Now let's see few miscellaneous questions which arrived in previous papers of placements or gate. ये क्वेश्चन के अंदर हमें बोला हुआ है कि SRTF that is shortest remaining time first algorithm use करनी है, and we know that shortest remaining time is preemptive scheduling and we have to calculate average turnaround time. So कुछ भी करने के लिए इसमें हमें पहले गैंट चार्ट बनाना पड़ेगा. So let's draw the Gantt chart first. यहां पे हमें दो burst time given है और एक IO burst given है. So that means first burst, then IO, then again burst. So three, then this two. Similarly, this is P1 के लिए 2, 4, 1. इसके लिए 1, 3, 2 और इसके लिए 2, 1, 2. इस तरह से हमें चलाना है. This is burst. This is IO. This is burst. Okay. So we have to do this. Now I am reviewing these things. Now let's start with zero. And at time zero, these two processes are available. Out of which this is the shortest. We cannot run it till whole time because it is preemptive. Now if we run it till one, it will become less. It was less already and it is becoming even lesser. So now at one, still we are having this processes available. So we will continue this. So if we continue this, the first burst time is over and it will go for IO burst. So this is, let's say till six, the IO burst is going to complete. Now at time two, you can see P2 has arrived. So out of these two processes, which is P0 and P2, which two are available, the burst time required is 3 and 1. Which one is shorter? P2. So we will schedule P2 till 1. So this is over and now it can go for burst. So if it is given that IO devices can be run parallelly, so we can start this for 3 IO. So 3 plus 3 is 6 and it will complete simultaneously with the previous process. Okay, now see the burst time at 3, this is not yet arrived. Okay, now at time 3 only P0 is available, which require 3 burst time. So till 5 we can run P0 and this burst time will remain 1. Okay. So now at time 5, P3 is available and P0 with burst time 1 is available. This is 2, this is 1. Which one is shorter? P0. So we will continue with P0 and run it till 6. So this burst time is over and it can go for its IO time. That is till 8. And at 5, this has arrived. At 6, P1 and P2 both have arrived. So now see this. At time 6, we have P1, P2, P3, all are available with required burst time. So P1 and P2 are available for the second chance. So that is 1 and 2. P3 is available for its first chance. That is 2. Okay. Now, if you see which one is having the lesser time required, which is 1. So we will schedule P1. Okay. P1 is scheduled till 7. Now P1 is over. Now see this, at time 7 only these two are available. Okay, and here if we see this is the lesser process ID. So we will schedule this P2 till what time? Till 1 only, because at this next time this process which is arriving from IO may have lesser burst time. So this is required 1. This is over already and P0 has arrived with a requirement of 2 now. So this is still lesser. So we will continue with P2 and this will finish. So P2 is finished. Now we have P3 and P0. So both required 2 time. So P0 is lesser. So now we will schedule P0 till 2, because if we run it with 1 also, then after running one burst time, it will become even shorter. So we will continue with this, and lastly we will run P3. So now see, P3 is scheduled till 2, but this P3 was the first chance. Now it will go for another IO for 2 seconds and it will come at 15, since only one process is available. So immediately it will be submitted for IO burst from 15 to 16, and this is ideal because no process is available. Okay, now let's see its start time. So for calculating turnaround time, we do not need start time, we will see the completion time and turnaround time. So see this, for P0, P1, P2, P3, process 0 is completing at 11, process 1 is completing at 7, process 2 is completing at 9, process 3 is completing at 16. So this was process 3. Okay, now turnaround time is completion time minus arrival time. So 11 minus 0 is 11, 7 minus 0 is 7, 9 minus this 2 is 7, and 16 minus 5 is 11. So average turnaround time will come out be 11 plus 7 plus 7 plus 11, that is 36 divided by total number of processes, that is 9.0 units. Okay, so our answer is 9 units. Okay, now let's see another question. Using priority scheduling, in priority scheduling the mode given is preemptive, we have to calculate all the other parameters. So first we will draw the Gantt chart for priority scheduling. At time 0, only one process is available, and here also 2 burst time, in between we have to run IO burst. So priority is lowest the number, highest the priority. Okay, at time 0 we will run for 1 burst time because no other process is available. So from 0 to 1 we have scheduled P0. This is over and it can go for IO burst of 5. It will come back at 6. Now from at point 1 we do not have any process, this will come at 2. So till from 1 to 2 it will be ideal. At 2 only one process is available, which is P1. We will run P1 till 1 and it will become 2. Now at time 3 this will also come. P1 is having priority 3, P2 is having priority 1. Which one is highest priority? Obviously P2. So we will run P2 till it first burst is completed, because the priority are static, it will not change. So we can safely run it till 5, and this will completed, and now it can go for IO, that is till 8. And in the meantime we have only one process available, which is P1. So we can run it till one process. Why? Because at 6 this P0 will also come. So till 6 P1 is completed and it will become it will reduce to 1. At time 6 this is available and this is coming for second chance. This is having the lowest priority, this is having little higher than this. So we will run the lowest priority till what time? Till the next process more highest than this arrives. So till 8 we have run it, so it will become 1 here. Now this is P0, and at time 8 we have P0, P1, P2. P0 wants 1 for second chance, P1 wants 1 for its first chance, and P2 needs 1 for its second chance. Okay, now see, P0 is 1, P2 is 1, P1 is 1. All are having one burst time, and they have asked us priority scheduling, which one is highest? P2. P2 is highest and we will run P2 till 9 and it will get completed, because P2 was running for second chance. So it is completed. Now out of P0 and P1, which one is highest? P0. P0 is also running for second chance. So we will run P1 till 10 and it is completed. Now we are remaining with P1. दिस हैज नॉट कंप्लीटेड इवन इट्स फर्स्ट चांस. सो नाउ पी, दिस इज पी जीरो. सो पी वन इज रनिंग टिल 11 एंड इट विल कंप्लीट इट्स फर्स्ट चांस एंड गो फॉर आईओ ऑफ 3 यूनिट्स, दैट इज टिल 14. एंड एट टिल 14 स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 11 दिस इज आइडियल एंड फ्रॉम 14 it will start its second chance. So till 15 it will run, okay, and this is not required, not required at all. Now see, if you calculate, you can calculate all the other things like turnaround time, waiting time, remain response time, but if you want to calculate the CPU percentage, that is utilization, so total time here is from 0 to 15, and now the total useful time is from 0 to 1, 2 to 11 and 14 to 15. So total useful time is total time minus not useful time, and not useful time is this one. This is 1 and this is 3. So total unuseful is 4. So if I minus 15 minus 4, we will get 11. That is useful. Multiply by 100 and it will give us total percentage of CPU utilization. Okay, all the other things you can calculate. I think this question came in GATE 2006 and in Kochlup's MCQ also. In actually Kochlup's MCQ, this question have came for 2-3 times, and it is important to understand this question. So now see, consider three processes all arriving at time 0. So we have to draw the chart ourselves. So three processes P0, P1, P2, all arriving at time 0 0 0 0, with total time execution is 10, 20, 30 units respectively. Each process spends its first 20% of execution time doing IO. So I am writing burst time here, and in burst time IO, first 20% of each 10, 20, 30. So 20% of 10 is 2, 20% of 20 is 4, 20% of 30 is 6. Okay, next 70% of doing computation, that is on CPU. So CPU burst time. So 70% of 10 is 7, 70% of 20 is 14, 70% of 30 is 21. Last 10% doing IO again. So last 10%, what is remaining? So 10% of 10 is 1, 10% of 20 is 2, 10% of 30 is 3. Okay, the operating system uses the shortest remaining time first. So that is SRTF, which is preemptive, we know that. Okay, schedule a new process either when running process gets blocked or IO, or when the running process finishes its compute burst, that we already know. Assume that all IO process can be overlapped, so that means parallel processing of IO can be possible. For what percent of time does the CPU remains ideal? So that means 100 minus CPU utilization. Okay, now let's see this by drawing its Gantt chart. At time 0, all the processes are available and they will start doing its IO. So this P0 is completing IO at 2, P1 is completing its IO at 4, and P2 is completing its IO at 6. So till 2, no process is available, so it is ideal time. Okay, now when this P0 will come out of IO, we have 7 burst time remaining. Okay, so now see, if I run till 2 also, this P0 is running till 2 also, so it will become 5 and this will be available, and still this shortest time is 5, so I will run it P0 only till 6, because at 6 this is also coming, so it will become 3, and at 6 this is still is shortest, so I will continue with this till 9. So this P0 is completed its IO and CPU burst and can go for another IO, that is till 10. So here this P0 is completed. Now at 9, this and this both are available. Why? Because see here, this is available at 4, this is available at 6. So both are available at 9. Which one to choose? Having the lowest burst time. So you can see here, if I reduce it, so it will become even shorter. So in one go only, I can finish this process. So from 9 to 23, I can finish P1. And it can go for another IO for 2 units, that is at 25, this is completed. Okay. At 23, only P2 is remaining, which is 21 processing time. So this is at 44, this P2 process CPU burst time is over and it can go for another 3 burst time. At 47, this process is completed. But from 44 to 47, we are not utilizing our CPU. So CPU is not utilized here and here, although the total time is from 0 to 47. So now what is CPU ideal time? Ideal percentage is, this is 2 time and this is 47 minus 44, that is 3. So 2 plus 3 is 5 divided by total time, which is 47 into 100, that is 10.6%. Okay, and the answer is B. Correct?